So I welcome you for watching this video. Here I am going to discuss some condition that is intussusception, and this intussusception is a very common problem in our state, particularly in Bihar. And a lot of cases refer to our veterinary college, and few veterinarians are also performing this surgery in field condition. So here I would like to brief about what are the typical signs and symptoms that you will observe in the cases of intussusception in dairy cattle. Second thing is how we finally come to the diagnosis that this case, this particular case could be a case of intussusception. And third one is management of this condition, whether we go for medicinal treatment or surgical treatment. So let's come to regarding diagnosis, how we come to diagnose these cases, or how we finally arrive at the diagnosis that this particular case belongs to intussusception or suffering from the intussusception. So first most important thing is a history or clinical sign symptom that was told by the owner. So mostly he will tell that uska animal theek se khana pina kha raha tha aur achanak jo hai pichla pair se apne pet ko marna start kar diya, like kicking off abdomen with hind limb. Now you see here, and utna baithna start kar di, bahut bechansi ho gayi. So this type of clinical sign symptom in animal is a indicative of colic. So this is the typical characteristic colic sign symptom that was that is to be observed in the animal suffering from this GI tract. So next one is the next important things that I notice is a feeding. The most of the cases that I encountered in this place, particularly in Bihar, owner ka wo matlab feeding history jo batata hai, wo kehte hain ki sani ke upar hum aata cheet dete hain taki sani jo hai thoda palatable ho jaye और एनिमल उसको अच्छे से खा ले. तो आटा वो सानी के ऊपर छींटते हैं. सो स्प्रिंकलिंग ऑफ दिस व्हीट फ्लोर, दिस वन ऑफ द प्रीडिस्पोजिंग फैक्टर आल्सो फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर कंडीशन इंटुसेप्शन. एंड आल्सो दे रिपोर्टिंग दैट दे आर नॉट as per schedule in deworming their animal. So these are the most important clinical sign symptom and history you will get from the owner. Next one is owner aapko ye bhi bolega ki ye sign symptom hone ke baad jo hai uska janwar jo hai gobar karna band kar diya, and animal completely stop the passing of the dung. And generally it happens that if the colic happens now, then the animal is stop passing the dung after 12 to 24 hours. It take at least 12 to 24 hour time when there is a complete cessation of the passing of the dung. So next part is you go for examination of the animal for final diagnosis. So if you examine this type of animal or animal having this type of sign and symptom, then on per rectal examination you will find typically raspberry jam like mucus coating on your hand, and also you will find sausage sapid soft tissue structure on per rectal examination. That is that you may not find in advanced pregnancy, and also it is not common in all cases that you may find this subsessus apertus structure. And finally, for final diagnosis, if we have a facility for ultrasonography, then you have to go for right abdomen, flank, and distal part is ultrasonography of this area. So, how we differentiate whether the problem is existing in the rumen or it is related with the intestine? So, particularly for this case, if the problem is in the rumen, then you will find distension in the left side of the abdomen. And if the problem is existing in the intestinal part, then the distension you will observe in the right side of the flank. So particularly this is the case of intussusception that we have operated here in Bihar Veterinary College Teaching Veterinary Hospital. So you will find typical distension in the right flank distal part area, and this is how I say this is a raspberry jam like mucus, right? This kind of pasty or slimy kind of dung you will observe in the rectum while doing rectal palpation, and also in some animal you will find subsessus apertus intestinal mass. That is a clear cut indication that more than 95% cases this could be a case of intussusception. Then next we come to the final decision. As intestine is a soft tissue structure, so ultrasound is the best tool for diagnosis of the intestinal affection. So first, before going to the abnormality, we see the normal intestine, how it looks on the monitor while doing ultrasonography. So this one is a normal intestine. You will find this ingesta is flowing here and there, flow of the ingesta, and also the intestinal lumen. Intestinal lumen is, or lumen diameter is varying. Like you see here, contraction and expansion that indicate there is a normal peristaltic movement in the intestine. And next one is a ileus. In case of ileus, the intestine remain in the distended position and diameter is not varied. That indicates there is no peristaltic movement in the intestine and it is a functional disorder. Right? Next one is a intestine obstruction. How the obstructed intestine looks on the monitor while doing the ultrasonography of the right side of abdomen. Now see, there is a free flow of ingesta and the intestine is distended. It appears a mosaic-like pattern. And the lumen of the intestine or diameter of the intestine, if you scan on the transverse section, it varies. That means intestinal motility is there, but intestine is distended. And if it is a case of intussusception, then you will find this target-like appearance on cross-section of the intestine. So this is the case of intussusception. Here you will see this target-like appearance. This type of target-like appearance is not here. So if you, while doing ultrasonography, if the intestine part is looking like this, then we can able to confirm that this could be a final case of, finally a case of intussusception. So this is how the intussusception looks if you see through the naked eye. So this one is the proximal part of the intestine, and this one is the distal part of the intestine. This proximal part of the intestine get invaginated in the adjacent part of this intestine. So the part of the intestine that enter inside the adjacent part we call intussusceptum, and the part of the intestine that is inciting or present outside of this intussusceptum part that we call intussuscipient. Okay, so this condition is very painful because you see the mesentery is also inter with the intestine, and the stretching of the mesentery is very painful, and that's why the animal feel very colic type of sign. That's why the animal showed colic type of sign and symptom due to a stretching of the mesentery. Animal feels severe pain. So if you see the cross section under the ultrasound, you will find round this mosaic kind of pattern. But if you see the cross section of this structure, you will have multiple layer of the intestine. So the multiple layer of intestine, it looks like this. This portion will look like this, and target like appearance, bull like appearance. So this one is the confirmation that this could be a case of intussusception. So if you there is a report that the intussusception is most common in the small intestine. It is 84% cases observed thereof in a small intestine, and 11% in holocolic, and 2% in ileocolic. So major part of the intestine that is affected with the intussusception is a small intestine, and among the small intestine we can say this duodenum, jejunum and ileum. The jejunum and ileum part of the intestine is mostly involved. So this one is the colonoscopy of this dog in which we have diagnosed the intussusception. So if you see under colonoscopy, this is how this invaginated part, intussusceptum part, looks. Okay, so next one is how we manage this case. So if there is a severe colic, so immediately we have to give any antispasmodic drug like flunixin, meglumine, dicyclomine, fortrine. So I prefer to use flunixin, meglumine, because this one will give coverage for 24 hours. But if you use dicyclomine, you have to give at the interval of 6 to 8 hours. And fortrine also, that is a short duration action. So you have to repeatedly give to manage the colic. Second thing, the animal is dehydrated also. So you have to go for fluid therapy. And generally, we prefer to give 10 to 15 liters of fluid per day through IV route. And the choice of the fluid is normal saline, or the animal suffering from this intussusception is also hypocalcemic. Sometimes if the case is of old one, like 5 to 6 or 7 days back case, then animal may become recumbent mainly due to hypocalcemia or hypokalemia. So if you give a calcium supplement or calcium borogluconate intravenously, immediately that animal stand. So fluid therapy is essential for stabilization of this particular case. So next is a surgical management. So if you diagnose the case of intussusception, you try to manage this case with the help of fluid therapy and calcium. Sometime it get relieved. Try wait for 1 or 2 days. keep on medicinal treatment so that animal will stabilize also and properly rehydrated also. And also 2 to 3 times you try to massage the abdomen or apply jerk on the stomach. Sometimes it gets relieved automatically. And if still it is not responding, then you have to go for surgical treatment. And for surgery, you have to perform laparotomy through right flank. And if the intussusception is of recent occurrence, or we can say within 2 days or 3 days, sometime in 4 days also, it may relieve by just by pulling the part that is, or pushing the part that is invaginated inside the intestine. I will show you next slide. And sometimes what happens is, due to vascular compromise, the part of the intussusception part get necrosed and we have to remove it. And also due to adhesion, we are not able to relieve the intussusception part. And in that case also, we have to take the decision that we have to reset and we have to anastomose the resected part. So this is how, if the case is of recent past of 2 days or 3 days, or we can 4 days also, and animal is properly rehydrated, then just you try to relieve the intussusception. Now you see, I am relieving this intussusception. Here we need not to go for intestinal resection, right? Or resection of anastomosis. It will relieve. Now you see how it's, I am relieving, just pushing here. Now you see, this is the junction where the intestine get enters. So this is how we relieve completely. Okay. So what we do here, where the intestine is healthy one, not necrosis, and proper vascularization is there, so there is no need to resect and anastomose this part. So in future also, or immediately after relieving, this junction again won't enter in the adjacent part of the intestine. So what we do here, we do interoplication. That means this adjacent intestine, mucosa to mucosa, we put simple interrupted suture pattern so that it will further not enter inside the adjacent part, right? That is for taking the you see how it get enter inside, right? How it enters, right? So we relieve it. And in next slide, this is how when we go for resection anastomosis, then we remove the necrosis part or the part that is severely adhered and not relieved normally. Then the end of the intestine, we perform anastomosis with the help of 3-0 suture material. Either we can use catgut or Vicryl. First layer in a simple continuous pattern, then second layer we can use Cushing pattern or Lambert pattern, whatever, both we can go for suturing. Then next thing is a post-operative care. So once we operate this animal, we keep the animal off it for next 2 days. We don't offer any water or feed to the animal at least 2 days, and we maintain on intravenous fluid during this 2 days condition. And from third days, we start giving the lipid part, and also we can supplement green in a small quantity, and we give this antibiotic for 5 to 7 days, analgesic for 3 days, then we supplement with the multivitamins, and a strict food therapy on 2 days, minimum 2 days. Okay, then gradually we start to incorporating this green part, and then with roughages also. So once we start feeding and animal started to pass the feces, so there is no leakage and there is no problem, animal will cure 100%, and further there will be no any complications. So this is all about this intussusception. Thank you.